Hi everyone! Back in December we went on a day trip to Zealandia, which is a bird sanctuary here in Wellington City. There is a little boat that takes you on a trip across the reservoir so you can see the sanctuary from the water. We got to see lots of shags or cormorant birds, some of which were very curious and swam right up to the boat. Their feathers are actually not waterproof, which allows them to dive and fish more easily, but they need to dry off before going back into the water. Looking back across the lower dam, you can see the Gothic style wooden building, which is a very pretty decorative housing for the water outlet control tower. Almost immediately we saw the rarest duck in the world, the pateke, or brown teal. You might remember I did a painting of a brown teal last year to support Wellington Bird Rehabilitation Trust. I will put a link to the Trust's website in the video description, as they do a lot of work to help sick and injured birds. Walking tracks winding their way through the bush over streams and past amazing native plants and trees, like this giant tree fuchsia. Unfortunately, we were a bit late for this one to be in flower, as they only flower from August to December. We made our way up to the top dam, and the view from there back over the valley is spectacular. You can see the reservoir or lower dam we crossed on the boat just in the middle of the screen there. Here is our beautiful native wood pigeon, the kereru, which is an important part of the native ecosystem. This is because it is the only remaining bird large enough to eat and then disperse the fruits of some native trees like the tawa and the karaka. These beautiful chatty saddleback birds are making a comeback. By the early 1900s, they were nearly extinct in New Zealand. Now they are flourishing in island sanctuaries throughout the country. Zealandia was the first mainland sanctuary to receive saddleback birds in 2002. The tour Thanatara is a very special endemic reptile that has been around since the time of the dinosaurs. If you look carefully as you walk along the paths in Zealandia, you might see them enjoying the afternoon sunshine just at the entrance of their burrows. Zealandia's population of brown-tailed ducks is doing well, with an estimated minimum of 10 breeding pairs present in 2006. It is difficult to know an exact count of the population as they are spread all throughout the valley. As we made our way back along the lake road towards the entrance of the sanctuary, we came across this beautiful view of the water outlet control tower, and I decided that I would like to try painting this view in watercolours. I took a few photos for reference and we continued on. Just before the entrance, there is a little lawn where you can walk over to the water outlet control tower, and this is also where you catch the boat across the reservoir. It's also where a paradise shell duck is busy raising their duckling. The ducks are so pretty, and we stopped to watch them for a little bit. To get a better shot, my husband put his GoPro down on the footpath. Even though the camera was placed well away from the duck and behind the rope, this was apparently still a little too close for the duck's liking. The mother duck charged the GoPro. We very carefully picked up the camera and backed even further away from the grassy area, but by now the duck was completely offended and made sure to see us off properly. This painting took about 3 days to complete in different stages. You can see here that I'm adding some masking fluid, and I'm using a Pebeo drawing gum pen to do this. These are really useful. They are like paint pens, so you can press down and the masking fluid flows out, and you can actually just draw with them like a paint pen and draw where you need the masking fluid to be. This is really helpful for small details in little areas, so if you need to do leaves or tree branches or any small details that need to be masked out so that you can come back and add different colours later on, it's a really useful tool for that. So here I'm adding some darker green washes to that first layer of paint that's already down on the paper, and this whole painting is basically a process of adding a layer of colour, waiting for it to dry, and then repeating the process again and again, and then lifting up some masking fluid, occasionally painting, putting some masking fluid down in a slightly different area. And that part of the process was a little bit difficult because I really had to think ahead and think about where I wanted the masking fluid to be ahead of time. A couple of cases I did mess it up a little bit and put the masking fluid in the wrong place or forget to lift it up, but I managed to correct that later on in the process. So here you can see I'm just adding layers of darker and darker green to those hills in the background on the other side of the valley. And I basically added some very dark green near the base and then lighter, more yellowy, summery green at the top of those hills, just to try and get the effect of the sunlight hitting the tops of those hills across the valley there. And then I do the same to the foreground area, so I wet the paper with some water and then I start adding in some dark green in the shadow areas in the foreground and just letting that flow about there and do its thing, and then go back in and add some lighter green on top. So here is about where I realised I messed up. So you can see that I've added a few leafy textures there, and then I erased, using a very tiny eraser, that line of masking fluid along the top of the bushes, and realised of course that I had a beautiful white line along the edge of the lake there and the edge of the bushes, and I should have taken that masking fluid off earlier. And this process is just repetition as well, so adding those lighter and then darker colours, layering them, building up this whole area. So I will leave you guys to enjoy the rest of the time lapse. It's basically more of the same. Please enjoy this as I build up the painting bit by bit. There are a few colours that I would have liked to have been brighter and more saturated, but overall I was pretty happy with how this turned out. Enjoy! Thank you. Okay, so here we are in the very final stages of the painting, and I mentioned earlier that I wished some of the colours were a little bit more saturated, and I think in particular the red on the roof of the water house there, or the water control tower, is what I wish would have been a little bit more saturated, a little brighter, but overall it's about the right colour. Yeah, just basically adding the last few details and letting everything dry before I take off any last remaining bits of masking fluid that I might need to, although I think I've already done that at this point, and then removing the masking tape from around the picture itself, leaving a nice crisp border around the painting. Last bit of the masking tape is off. Doesn't that look nice? Well, thank you very much for watching, everyone. I will be back again soon with another art video. So until next time, have a really great day, and yeah, I'll be back again soon. Bye!